Okay, so now that we have those basic ones down, let's do one more, a little bit more complex. Now, let's pretend that I have 2x minus 1 over 3 equals 7. So absolute value 2x minus 1 over 3 equals 7. Remember, the idea is to have the absolute value by itself on one side of the equation. In this case, it's by itself. Nothing is adding or subtracting or multiplying. So by itself. So here, I just can go straight to solve. So I'm going to have 2x minus 1 over 3 equals 7. Or, right, 2x minus 1 over 3 equals negative 7. So the idea with every single absolute value equation is I'm going to have a positive answer and negative answer. So let's keep solving this. Absolute value by itself, two different answers, one positive, one negative. Now we got to solve this first. So the first thing that we have to solve here is that we have a 3 dividing. What's the opposite of division? Multiplication. So I need to multiply on both sides. Multiply on both sides. Okay, that 3, before I start distributing, which is what a lot of people do first, is that 3 I multiply so I can cancel the denominator. All right, the 3's will cancel. 3 divided by 3 is 1, so it canceled out. And I'll have the 2x minus 1 on top. On the other side, I have 7 times 3, which is 21. Let me make a little line over there. And from here, I just finish solving it. So I'm going to have opposite of negative 1, positive 1 on both sides. Whatever you do on one side, you're doing the other side of the equation. Negative 1 plus 1 is going to be 0. So I'm going to have 2x, 21 plus 1 is 22. And your last step is to get rid of whatever's multiplying the x by dividing on both sides. And now I'm going to have x equals 11. As we learned before, I'm going to have OR. Okay, technically talking, we need to have an OR right there. Now here, same process as this one. The 3 is dividing, so I'm going to multiply by 3 and multiply by 3. Make sure that you put a parenthesis there so you understand that you're multiplying those two numbers. Another common mistake is people don't put the parenthesis and they say, oh, negative 7 plus 3. All right, remember that we're multiplying. So 3 divided by 3 cancels out, and I'm going to have 2x minus 1 equals negative 7 times 3, negative 21. Follow up the same process that I did previously. Plus 1, and I'm going to have 2x equals negative 21 plus 1 is negative 20. Excellent. Different sign. You subtract and you keep the sign of the bigger one. Last step, divided by 2, and x equals negative 10. So my answer will be x equals 11 or x equals negative 10. Now, something that you might want to do is every time you're solving something with a long process like this, you might want to plug those answers back and see if it works. Let's replace. So I'm going to have absolute value of 2x minus 1 over 3 equals 7. Let's plug the x equals 11 first. So 2 times 11 minus 1 over 3 equals 7. I'm not erasing the absolute value, I'm checking my answers. That's what I'm doing right now. So 2 times 11 is 22 minus 1 over 3. 22 minus 1 is 21 over 3. 21 divided by 3 is 7. An absolute value of 7 is 7. So it's going to check that out. Now, let's do the same process with the negative 10. Now, excellent. So instead of the x, I'm going to replace it by negative 10. Negative 10. 2 times negative 10, negative 20. Right? Now, I didn't erase the whole thing. I'm just replacing the value of x. So x is going to be negative 10. 2 times negative 10 is negative 20. Minus 1 is negative 21. Negative 21 divided by 3 is negative 7. Again, absolute value of any number will always give you a positive value, which confirms my previous answer. So every time you solve an absolute value equation or a big problem, you might want to double check your answers to make sure that you did it right.